Well, have you ever heard of Generation Alpha? That's the name bestowed on kids born between 2010 and 2024. Currently, they make up more than one in seven Australians and within the next 4 years are projected to outnumber baby boomers. So, what's in store for them? Author and social researcher Ashley Feld has just co-written a fascinating book about the topic and she joins us now. Ashley, very good morning to you.
Good morning.
Hey, so Ashley, we've got Generation X, Generation Y, Generation Z, we've got Millennials. Now we've got Generation Alpha. Who comes up with these names?
Yeah, there's lots of different people who tend to name generations, and for Generation Alpha, it was Mark McCrindle who co-authored this book with me. So about a decade ago, or just over actually, before they began being born, he realised that no one was thinking about the next generation and that we'd come to the end of the alphabet with Gen Z. So he did what we do as researchers. He did a survey of Australians, and a lot of people said Generation A or Generation Technology, but he drew on the scientific nomenclature of drawing to the Greek alphabet, and that's what we've done. We've named them Generation Alpha.
Generation Alpha it is. So tell us, Ashley, about Generation Alpha.
Yeah, well, of course, this generation began being born in the year 2010, and that was the same year that the first iPad was released into consumers' hands. It was the same year Instagram launched. It was the word of the year in that year was the word app. And so I think that tells us a lot about the fact that this generation are living in an entirely new world, an entirely new century. Many of them will live into the 22nd century, which is quite hard to believe. But we know that they're very digital, they're very globally connected, they're very mobile in terms of the jobs they'll have and the careers that they'll move through. So a few very key differences compared to generations of the past, like you said, the Gen Zs, the Millennials and even the Boomers.
Indeed. So the oldest of this generation are kids aged 11 and they are all living through this world-changing pandemic. How will that potentially change how they live their lives in decades ahead?
Yeah, it's certainly going to be, I think, the defining social marker for this generation in the same way that September 11 was for the Millennials and man walking on the moon for the baby boomers. This is certainly going to be something that this generation will remember. But even the youngest of them probably won't remember the actual pandemic because we're talking about the kids that haven't even finished being born yet. They'll continue to be born until 2024. But even work from home, the future of work, how that's going to change, the increase of technology in our lives, which helped this generation do school through the pandemic. So I think there's certainly going to be some longer and lifestyle change that they're going to experience because of the year that we've just had with COVID.
And these kids are absolute digital natives, that they live on screens. I guess, and the book's good on this, what advice is tossed in for parents in terms of how they can best nurture and care for their children who, in some cases, sadly, become addicted to their screens?
Yeah, absolutely. And it's interesting because we navigate that tension that many parents are feeling with Generation Alpha and parenting them. So they want them to be tech savvy. They want them to have those digital skills because that's the world they're going to move into. But they also know that they need to develop those skills off screens and the interpersonal skills and time in nature. So we explore that tension that parents are facing. And for many parents, they're doing some great work and some great suggestions from the focus groups and the surveys we ran for the book around how to spend time off screens, how to have screen-free family time, and how to develop those interpersonal skills, communication skills, leadership skills, all of those things we know are going to be really important for this generation because they will work in more machine-assisted workplaces. And anything that machine can do, it will do. But what we need humans to do is to have those interpersonal leadership communication skills. So anything we can do to help this generation prepare for that future of work and help them thrive in this great screen age is what we explore in the book.
Oh, absolutely. And as I said, so many great tips in the book on that front. And finally, Ashley, what sort of consumers will these kids be when they reach shopping age? Some might have already, of course, on their screens with online shopping. But what sort of, generally speaking, consumers will they be in the decades ahead?
Yeah, it's interesting to think about children today as consumers. We always want to walk that line really finely. But even today, we know that, you know, the oldest of these kids are influencing the household decisions around consumption. And we think, of course, they're going to be digital. They're going to be globally connected to brands and products. And of course, they're going to be mobile, shopping anywhere, mobile first for them. We also believe they will be a real ethical consumer. We're seeing that already with their older Gen Z siblings and their they are looking for products and brands that have sustainability. We've seen the impacts of that when they don't, with cancel culture and things like that, which we explore in the book, the positives and the challenges with even the concept of cancel culture. So, yeah, if brands and organisations can make sure that they're digital, they're global, they're mobile first, and they are ethically founded on some great principles, because we know this generation are going to be purpose-driven and expect great things from the brands they engage with.
Ashley Fell, I'm sure the book will be great interest of all the viewers with kids in the Generation Alpha cohort. Thank you so much for joining us this morning.
Thanks for having me.
That sounds fantastic. I love Generation Alpha.
Yeah.
I've got a couple.
Alpha is such a strong word, isn't it? Very evocative word.
You know, you were just saying that I've actually got a couple of kids in that generation at home, and they are definitely the alphas in the family. Yeah. There is no question about who is running our house.
But gee, the screen issue is so important, and we hear it so often on this show, so worrying for so many parents of these kids.
Yeah, incredibly worrying. So good to hear that there's a bit of advice in there. We need all the help that we can get on that front.